What is love? Baby, don't hurt me. Don't hurt me.
No more.
No, sorry. What I meant is, what is love from a neuroscience perspective? Welcome back to Neuro Transmissions. I'm Alie Astrocyte, and this week we've got love on the brain.
Yes.
So, what is love? Well, of course we don't know everything. If I did, I'd be making a fortune selling love potions. But as we learn more about the human brain, we're learning more about the neuroscience of love. Love comes in many forms, but let's divide it into three categories for our purposes: lust, romantic love, and attachment. Lust is that first rush of sexual attraction you feel when you meet someone new. From an evolutionary perspective, lust is what drives mating, and as a result, babies. We know that lust is driven at least in part by the sex hormones estrogen and testosterone. Interestingly, testosterone goes down in males but goes up in females during this passionate phase. At the start of a new romantic relationship, levels of cortisol, a stress hormone, quickly rise, which contributes to the excited, nervous butterflies you might feel in your stomach. Research has also shown that when someone is infatuated, they have reduced brain activity in regions like the frontal cortex, which is important for judgment and decision-making. This may be why it's difficult to keep your head straight when you're falling in love. They say that love is blind, but it seems like love is just irrational. Beyond lust, romantic love drives our attraction to a specific person. It's what keeps us in a relationship when that initial lust dials itself back a bit. Evolutionarily, it can be described as choosing an appropriate mate. Humans have to invest a lot of time and energy into raising a child, so mate selection is important. You need to pick someone who will be around for at least a few years. Some clickbaity headlines have described falling in love as just like addiction. This is because love causes the release of a number of different neurotransmitters in the brain, like norepinephrine, dopamine, and serotonin. These neurotransmitters have particularly potent effects in the brain's pleasure centers. These pleasure centers are spread across the brain, but include structures like the amygdala, which is linked to emotional responses, and the nucleus accumbens, which is important for motivation and reward. Dopamine is an especially potent neurotransmitter. It contributes to the euphoric sensation of being in love, activating a lot of that reward circuitry in the brain. Basically, being in love makes you feel good. So when reporters claim that love is just like a drug, what they really mean is that falling in love activates a lot of the same pathways as using stimulant drugs, such as amphetamines and cocaine. But don't worry, cocaine and love don't really have much in common otherwise. Attachment is the love of a parent, a close friend, or a long-term partner. Attachment is important for maintaining long-term relationships, if that's your thing, and for maintaining familial and social connections. It makes you feel safe and cozy when you're with a person, but you don't necessarily have to like them to feel this strong attachment. It helps keep relationships together for years and years. This type of love seems to be driven by other brain chemicals like oxytocin and vasopressin. Oxytocin is sometimes called the trust hormone. It's often released during acts of touching, such as cuddling, and provides a sense of comfort. Think about how nice a hug from a good friend feels on a bad day. You can thank your oxytocin for that. On a deeper physical level, oxytocin is the hormone that triggers contractions and lactation during pregnancy and birth. The release of this hormone during birth is also associated with mother-child bonding. Vasopressin, on the other hand, is known primarily for its role in maintaining blood pressure and cardiovascular function. It's also nicknamed the attachment hormone and seems to play a larger role in attachment bonding in males, since they don't get some of the benefits of oxytocin. Both of these hormones together lead us to feel comfortable and relaxed with our close friends and family, and keep us together even when they're driving us nuts. Of course, love is more complex than what I've described. There are a lot of social and philosophical quandaries surrounding the idea of love and passion that we're not able to delve into today. Regardless of your feelings on love, and Valentine's Day, I hope that you learned a little something new today. Thanks for watching this special episode of Neurotransmissions. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button for more videos about the brain. I love making these videos and I hope you'll stick around as we continue to explore. Until next time, I'm Alie Astrocyte. Over and out.